Hi everyone, it's Leontine from Little Lovely Crafts. It's been a while since I posted my last video, and today I wanted to show a gift box I made using a sweet pumpkin on the front. And I'm going to show you how I made it, so if you like it, you can make it as well. There is a little surprise with this gift box because the pumpkin is a shaker, and I put little star sequins in there to make it fit with the whole theme of the box. I'm going to show you all the supplies that you need in order to make this gift box. Of course, the Lawn Fawn gift box dies, and I use the stars from the Say What gift tags. I use the outside in stitched pumpkin and some starry sequins. I used glue dots and some foam tape. In this case, it's 2 millimeters thick. And I used a bit of acetate for the shaker part, black cardstock, orange cardstock from Lawn Fawn, some green cardstock from Lawn Fawn, some white cardstock and starry pattern paper. And of course you'll need your usual supplies like a bone folder, scissors and some glue. To save some time in this video, I'm gonna die cut everything and I'm gonna show you how to assemble the box. Okay, here I have the top and the bottom of the box. I'm gonna use some score tape on the tabs, and I use score tape because it's a lot less messy than glue and it's very strong as well. I'm putting it on all four of the tabs. I'm using my bone folder to apply some pressure on the tape to make sure that it really sticks. I'm peeling off the release paper, and then it's just a matter of attaching everything to the back of the paper. Behind the scenes, I already folded all the lines that the die created for me, and I used a bone folder to really enhance the crease so it's nice and crisp. And look how easy it is to finish it. The bottom of the box is all done. Now we're gonna go on to the top of the box, and as you can see, I cut off the tabs and I made two of those little holes in there with the die that came with the set. And to finish it off, we're gonna use those four scalloped triangle pieces, I guess, and I'm gonna use some tape runner on it. And then Lawn Fawn showed us in the video they're attaching it like that, but for some reason I just like it better upside down, so I'm attaching it that way. You can choose however you want to do it, of course, but this is my favorite way. I had a little bit of trouble with the tape runner. It seemed to stick to the paper and rip it off a little bit, so I'm using just a drop of glue on the top bit there. And for the other triangles, I'm gonna make sure that the tape runner goes onto the paper without tearing it. I'm making sure that I'm covering the entire piece with tape runner because I don't want my box with four corners that are hanging a bit loose. And now the entire box is finished. We can go ahead and make the pumpkin. I already die cut some orange cardstock, and I used the face for it as well. I cut two pieces of acetate, and I'm using the tape runner to attach the acetate. I always find that a tape runner just makes it a lot easier because it doesn't have to dry and it sticks very well. Making sure to go all around the face and the eyes. And When I put the acetate on, I apply some pressure until I can see every little glue bubble just sticking to the acetate. I'm gonna get my foam tape, and I start by putting the foam tape in the middle of the pumpkin's face. That's the easiest way because it's almost a straight line, and I'm using scissors to cut just exactly the length that I need for this. And because the foam tape is so thin, it's easy to make some turns and bends on the paper. And I'm cutting it always a little bit longer than I need, and then I tuck in the foam tape behind the previous piece. That way I make sure that none of the glitter can escape. Before I move on to filling the shaker part, I'm gonna attach the little stem of the pumpkin, and I made sure that the acetate is a little shorter around the stem so the paper actually glues to the paper. Before I put the sequins in, I always go around the foam tape with my powder tool. In my opinion, it makes sure that the sequins don't get stuck on it. I always put in either too many or too little sequins, but in this case it's easy. I can just look at the mouth and the eyes, and if they are covered with stars, then I've got enough sequins in there. Now I can pull off the liner paper and attach the top piece of acetate. And the reason that I put acetate on top is because I want the black of the box to shine through the eyes of the pumpkin. That way I don't have to put any heavy cardstock behind it, because, well, it was gonna be black anyway, and the box is black, so win-win. I've used the sort of like ribbon dye on the starry paper, and I don't need all of it. I'm gonna cut it off because I'm gonna make it look like the ribbon is around the box, but it actually only is on the top layer of the box. I'm gonna use a bone folder to make nice crisp edges. And I'm using my tape runner to apply some glue on it. And what I like to do to measure where it needs to go on the box is I look at the side of the box, and exactly in the middle of it, I'm gonna place the short side of the ribbon, and then I'm gonna fold it over to the front of the box. And I'm gonna do that on both sides until I'm happy where the placement is. And as you can see, I cut off the excess paper. And now comes the fun part. I'm gonna glue all of those white stars that I die cut earlier, and I'm just gonna place them randomly on the box, just as long as they're not too close to the pumpkin or to the ribbon. I'm gonna put some glue dots on the pumpkin. I'm gonna put it on the places where there's foam tape. And the reason I use glue dots instead of liquid glue, it's because if I put it on the box with liquid glue, there's a chance that it might shift around, and I don't want that. So I'm using glue dots to make sure that it sticks where it needs to stick. On my original box, I didn't decorate the sides, but I had enough stars anyway, so I decided to place them on the longer sides of the box. I didn't place any on the shorter sides because there's the starry pattern paper, so I thought it might be a little bit too much. I'm gonna continue using stars until I've used all of them, because it's a waste to throw them away. And with the last step done, the box is finished. It's so cute and quick and easy to make with all of the L'Enfant dies that I used today. And I know it's way too early, it's only May, and of course Halloween is in October, but I had this idea in my head and I just wanted to make it right away. I'm gonna leave it in my craft room and think about how I'm gonna fill the box, maybe with some cards that I'm gonna make or with some candy. Who knows? Got plenty of time to think about it. I hope you liked the video that I made today. Subscribe to my channel if you want to see more of my videos. For now, all I've got left to say is thank you for watching, and I'll hope to see you next time. Bye!